Hello, good day, and welcome to 4 Minutes Wisdom with Obinwa Chiazokam. I declare that you be blessed this week's podcast in the name of Jesus Christ. Now, this week we shall be discussing a topic titled Faith. Now, have you ever heard of the story of Charles Blondin? I read about him and I think I love his story. Let me just share it with you. Now, Charles Blondin was a tightrope walker who lived in the 19th century. He lived in the Niagara Falls region. He was famous for his tightrope walking feats. Once he tied a rope across Niagara Falls and walked on the rope from one point of the rope to the other end. Another time, he stopped in the middle of the rope and made omelettes with a stove and ate it and then continued to the other end. Now, another time, he walked on sticks. He put sticks on his shoes attached to his feet now and walked across the rope from one end to the other. Another time, he performed some stunts while on the rope and still made it to the other end. At one particular time, he also crossed with a wheelbarrow. Then he crossed again with the wheelbarrow, carrying his pet on the wheelbarrow. He crossed again with some of his family members on the wheelbarrow. Then carried his chairman, Harry Coco, across the wheelbarrow on the rope. Now each time he performed this feat, the crowd would cheer him as if they've seen the dead raised back to life. Now, among the crowd cheering Charles was a young man. He seemed to be his greatest fan. He clapped and jumped and danced like he was the one on the ropes. Now, Charles drew near to this young man and asked him, "Do you believe I can do this again?" He replied, "Yes, of course." And he asked him again, "Do you really believe I can do this?" Now, again, the young man replied, "I, of course, I'm sure you can. I've seen you do it again and again. I know you can do it again." Now, Charles asked again for the third time, "Are you sure that I can really do this?" And the man was almost angry. He was like, "Well, I, of course I know you can. I've seen you do it again and again. Of course you can do it." Now, Charles said to him, "Okay, get on the wheelbarrow." Oh, no. The man just, he disagreed. No, he said, no, I can't be the one on this wheelbarrow. Now, does that man describe you sometimes? I think yes. No, most times we say we believe God. But putting ourselves on the line according to what we believe is sometimes hard for us as Christians. Now, faith is actually action. It is not confession. The Bible said Jesus Christ saw the faith of those men that tore the rope to drop the paralytic man. So if your faith cannot be seen, if it is not in action, if only what you confess, you're always confessing, you're doing nothing to back up your confession, then it is not faith. If you believe God for a baby, why not start buying your baby clothes? If you believe God for exam success, why not write your desired result, paste it on your room for everybody to see? Or maybe start telling your friends, yeah, you've passed the examination. Faith is action. It is time for us to get on that wheelbarrow. Let's stop cheering the fans. Let's stop acting like the fans. Cheering others, cheering God, cheering the things he's doing for others. Why not put yourself on the line? No, Jonathan Franklin, in one of his books, The Fearless Life, he described faith as putting yourself in that position where if God does not come through for you, you are finished. That is the real faith. No matter what you want God to do for you, there is an action to back it up. My advice for you this week is to get on that wheelbarrow. You have shared other people's testimonies for long. You have cheered God. You said, "I believe." You said, I believe. Why not do something to back up what you believe this week? Your testimonies are sure this week in the name of Jesus Christ. So go out there, take your testimonies by faith. God bless you so much. Have a nice week ahead. And please take out time to share this with someone. And see you next week. God bless you.